This is part one of solving equations using the quadratic formula, and we solve this equation using the quadratic formula. Also, we do it by factoring and we check the solutions. This is part one of using the quadratic formula to solve equations. You should have already watched videos on using the square root property and completing the square and deriving the quadratic formula. So here's the quadratic formula equals if a x squared plus b x plus c equals 0, then x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So if we could put something in this form, a x squared plus b x plus c equals 0, then we can extract the values for a, b, and c and plug it into that formula. So here's an example. 5x squared equals 14x plus 3. The first step is to rewrite this so it's set equal to 0. So 5x squared minus 14x minus 3 equals 0, and then identify a, b, and c. A is the coefficient of x squared, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant. Okay, so here was our problem after we set the problem equal to 0 to put it in the form. Again, we would say what a, b, and c are equal to. And in the formula, we're just going to go plug in those numbers. So I'm going to plug in the a's, b's, and c's. So I've got negative b, so I could write negative. And then for b, you could plug in negative 14 plus or minus the square root. And then we could put negative 14 in for b here, negative 14 squared minus 4 times a, which is 5, and then c, which is negative 3. So that would be the whole numerator, and the denominator is 2 times a, which is 5. So you could just simply completely just plug in all those a's, b's, and c's directly in, but you do have, as you see, it's kind of a mess of numbers here. That's why I like breaking it down a little bit differently. And now I'm going to take the opposite of negative 14, which is positive 14, plus or minus. And now underneath the square root, we have to simplify. So first we have to do the squaring. So negative 14 squared, again, is negative 14 times negative 14. That's 196. And then I've got minus 4 times 5 times negative 3. So we have a negative and a negative. That's going to be a positive, and that'll give me 60. And in the bottom, I have it all over 10. And you still have to simplify inside the square root, which will be 256 all over 10. Then we want to write square root of 256 is 16, which is all over 10. So I finally get, that's what x equals, right? So then I could do x equals 14 plus 16 over 10. And we could simplify that going down the page if you want. 30 over 10 equals 3. Or x equals 14 minus 16 over 10, which is negative 2/10, or negative 1/5. Take a look again at how I began this problem. First, I set the equation equal to 0 to get it in standard form. I stated the values of a, b, and c, and then I plugged in the values of a, b, and c into this quadratic formula. And it's quite a fraction, and sometimes people make mistakes when they see all of this all at once. So an alternative way to do it, the way I like to do it, is I like to figure out what b squared minus 4ac is first. So b squared minus 4ac. I just like to figure out what's going to go under the square root. And I look up here and I see b is negative 14. So I do that in my head. What's negative 14 times negative 14? And of course you could use a calculator and you're going to get 196. And then it says minus 4ac. I like to do ac in my head as well. 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. So do you see how this would be b squared minus 4ac? So I'm doing the b squared, negative 14 times negative 14, and I'm doing the ac, 5 times negative 3. And now we simplify that. That's 196 plus 60, which is 256. All right, so we sort of worked that out ahead of time. I think you'll see this makes it a little bit less cumbersome to plug in the formula. So now the formula says it's the opposite of B. All right, so if B is, in fact, I'm going to write the formula again, negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4AC all over 2A. So now I'm going to replace negative B. I'm going to put in the opposite of whatever B is. So if B is negative 14, then the opposite of B is positive 14. Okay? Plus or minus. Now, it's just the square root of 256. Now, if it's a perfect square, let's write down what that would be. What would the square root of 256 be? Make sure you realize that's what would be underneath the square root, and that's 16. All over 2a, a is 5, so 2 times 5 is 10. So what I'm doing is I'm showing you how, instead of showing every single step here, it's easier to do a few of these in your head, otherwise it gets kind of crazy looking. But I'll do it the long way in a minute. All right, so this gives us two possibilities. X can either be 14 plus 16 over 10, which is 30 over 10, or 3, or X can be 14 minus 16 over 10, which is negative 2 over 10, or negative 1/5. So the solutions, if I didn't make any mistakes, are 3 and negative 1/5. First of all, if you use the quadratic formula or completing the square and you get answers that don't have any square roots, that means you could have also done the same problem by factoring, find the solutions by factoring. So for now, though, let's write down what these solutions are. The solutions are 3 and negative 1/5. Okay, this was our original problem. These were our solutions. Let's see if we would have gotten the same answer by factoring. So I'd have 5x squared minus 14x minus 3 equals 0, and then we try factoring. So I do by trial factors, but you can use any method you want to factor. Let's see, it's going to be 3 and 1 minus and plus. That's how to factor 5x squared minus 14x minus 3. And then we would set each factor equal to 0. And solve. So notice we still get x equals negative 1/5 and x equals 3. And for this particular problem, we could have found the solutions this way as well. Now, the other way to check your answers, of course, is to plug in these values one at a time into the original equation. So let's do that. We're going to take the original problem, 5x squared equals 14x plus 3, and first we'll plug in 3, then we'll plug in negative 1/5. All right, first let's plug in 3. Now, you, of course, could put the video on pause and try this on your own. So we're going to put in 3 for x, so that becomes 3 squared. And remember, order of operation, you have to do 5 times 9. You have to do the exponents first, and 5 times 9 is 45. On the other side, we have 14 times 3. Plus 3. So we have 42 plus 3, which is 45. So 3 also checks. And now let's go ahead and check the negative 1/5. This will be a little bit more involved. So we're going to plug in negative 1/5 for x. So we have 5 times, all right, when you do negative 1/5 times negative 1/5, that's 1/25. And then we can cancel. So this side reduces to 1/5. And on the other side, we have 14 times 1 times negative 1/5 plus 3. So I have negative 14/5. And I have to get a common denominator for 3. So I need to write that as fifths, and that will be 15/5. right? You multiply numerator and denominator by 5 to get 15 fifths, and negative 14 fifths plus 15 fifths is 1 fifth. So I got the same number on both sides, so that doesn't mean 1 fifth is the answer, it means that we checked and negative 1 fifth was the correct answer. Alright, so we did it by using the quadratic formula, we did it by factoring, and we checked both solutions.